surface nice. Obviously, they took it up the ceiling here. Yeah, that's still like nice 70s brown and like school carpet. But other than that.
Gentlemen, my name is Todd. Welcome aboard, folks. Train number
828,
Yamanar Builder.
Tier 4
unit. Ladies and gentlemen, if I could have your attention, please, let's get out here to Amtrak, folks. Just a quick scenic highlight here for you. We are currently passing Lake Tubman. This is the widest point on the northern Mississippi. This is a naturally occurring lake. This was not formed by dams. The water here is roughly 3 miles wide, although the deepest point is only about 35 feet. Now, for those of you with an imagination, there's a monster that lives up there. That is Pepe the Lake Monster. Can't be all that bad with a name like Pepe. It really can't be. So, anyway, folks, Lake Tubman.
Got the mac and cheese steak, milk, cookie. Bring the milk of a cottage game. Just throwing it in the now. What'd you get?
Chips.
Nice.
And turkey cheddar sauce.
Also nice.
Condiments.
No new menu, unfortunately. The day, train left the day before, so I don't think we had it on this one.
Nope. No review today.
No review today. Getting, you know, more so as time goes on. We've got super liners and we've got, well, let's got two P-42s up front, which is becoming less and less common. Ah, sure, why not? That's what being on the train's about, is making friends and meeting new people.
It's
so
crazy. It's very intense, interesting. It's all right, to say the least.
Yep. Yeah, this is my first time on Amtrak too. Yeah. Huh?
What did you think?
I thought it was alright.
It was stinky.
Yeah, a little bit.
Did you go in the observatory?
Yeah, for a little while.
Did you go from the observatory to like your car and you smell the difference?
Yeah, kind of.
It was fun.
Yeah.
I'm Raven.
Raven? I'm Ian.
Ian, I'm Raven.
To St. Louis.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. So we've got another 5 hours of train riding.
Bless your soul. What are you doing there?
Visiting a friend and then just kind of exploring the city.
Have fun.
Yeah, thanks.
Thank you, guys.
Nice to meet you.
Bye, my friend.
Alright, so first things first, we got deep dish waiting for us. So we gotta figure out how to get topside. I see an escalator right there.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
There's our old train heading to the yard. Holy hell, it's loud. Yeah. St. Louis, we're going up front. We got ventures. These are the new coaches.
All shiny
on the inside. Ah.
Business class cars are already here. Can't really see into them, unfortunately. Currently stopped just past Union Station, rather, due to maintenance personnel on the line. It's been going on like 20 minutes now, so we'll move as soon as they clear the line. This is the third time we've stopped. We are not even to our first stop yet at Summit. We're maybe like 5 miles from downtown. We're right by Midway Airport. So at this rate, we're probably going to get there sometime.
1 a.m.?
Yeah. I was going to go more like Saturday afternoon.
Joel is just realizing how far away we actually are.
So we need to go?
Yeah. Okay. That's where we are.
That's how far we got in an hour.
I'll call you and let you know how far I'm out.
My cog was for showing up high, so it's getting late, it's getting dark. I don't want to talk to you anymore, most likely because we don't trust. But it does seem at last we are moving. Also, ours smelled like burnt electronics. In fact, I can still kind of smell it out here. I should have tried to find a car number or something.
Yeah, I think it was just our car. I'm wondering if there's like a brake pad or something on it that's toasting.
Maybe.
Kind of smells like my old van, did it?
But it didn't smell like toasted brake pads. It smelled like burnt electronics.
It did,
Which, yeah. Which is an important distinction because our intercom didn't really work either. So I think something in there just fried. We are moving. It is 6:24?
Yep.
A.M. Monday the 22nd. 22nd. 4 days later, as planned.
On our outside to Chicago. Mm-hmm. Lincoln service.
Mm-hmm. 302. Did not get to spend much time here, but I think we still got a good impression of the station. In the area.
It's not the Union Depot here, but.
That is good.
It's like fine.
Mm-hmm.
serviceable. Mm-hmm. Guess it feels more like an airport, though.
It kind of does, yeah, I see it. I guess a little history about it. It was built in 2008 as a replacement for the Amshack that was on the same property. That was built in 78 to replace the old Union Station. It has 354,000 passengers in 2019, making it the busiest in the state of Missouri. Certainly one of the busier in the country, although I don't know the exact routine for it. 5 trains a day to Chicago, 2 to Kansas City, and then you've got the Texas Eagle down to Texas. Well, light rail connections, bus connections, both local and in the city. Drop tube, usually close to downtown Kansas City. Huh? Oh yeah. Got a train out there. Probably the River Runner as well. So like, well it is kind of a nicer station than Union Depot as far as like services. I feel like it doesn't feel like it, if that makes sense.
Empty.
Mm-hmm. I'll let you go. Even as it's full, it does, yeah, like, there's an emptiness to it.
Yeah.
It's got that slick sort of industrial chic design that's sort of meant to just, like, you know, take people in and spit them back out immediately.
Yeah. It's like an airport.
Yep. Like an airport.
About to go through TSA, but... Oh, God. Yep.
But everything else in mind, like, you know, it's got way better train service than Union Depot in St. Paul.
That's true. It's very true.
So I'm still giving it like a 7 out of 10.
Yeah. I think that's the same rating I gave in St. Paul. So.
Okay. Sure.
But what lacks in station, I make up for in trains.
Yeah.
Hey, it's Ian in post-production. Gonna clarify a few things I think I didn't do a great job of explaining. So in urbanism, there's this concept of places, a place being, you know, somewhere that you want to be. And one of the arguments against vehicle ownership is that it turns a lot of places into non-places, a lot of otherwise attractive destinations into just flat, boring parking lots or other such structures. And I think St. Louis Gateway Station is closer to the latter here. Between the fact that it's shoved under 8 lanes of highway traffic and a couple of off-ramps, and is surrounded by a sea of parking, you know, despite all the other things going for it, despite the transit connections, despite being right in the middle of downtown St. Louis, you know, it doesn't feel like that's the case. It feels like you're meant to get whisked away by someone there ready to pick you up as soon as you're there, and not, you know, try to use these services to get to your hotel room at 1 in the morning, even though the last train left about a half hour ago, and there's no buses either. So anyway, that's why I'm giving it a lower rating than St. Paul Union Depot, even though the things that make Union Depot a place kind of act to the detriment of it also being a transit hub. But that's neither here nor there. Anyway, have a good week.